everyone, and welcome back to Art with Miss Choate. I hope you've had a wonderful week so far. So to end off our week, our first week of art making back at school, we are going to make a really fun pinwheel. And today, all you're going to need is some paper, anything you want to color with or make marks with or designs, and a pencil. So we're going to be attaching our paper pinwheel onto our pencil. So I'm gonna attach it with a push pin. If you don't have a push pin, you can use a regular pin, or we could tape it on. Whatever you want to do, we can do that. So we don't need a lot of supplies for today. We just need our imagination, and let's go get started.
So the first thing we're gonna do, you can grab some colorful paper, or you can just use white paper, that's up to you, is we're gonna be cutting our paper into a square. Now, a simple way you can do this is by folding this over, but for our pinwheel, we don't want to crease it, so I'm just using that as a guide so I know right here is all my extra. So I'm just going to take a pencil, and I'm going to lightly mark, and if you have a ruler, then you could just measure it, make sure that this side is the same as this side. And once you have one marked, you can go ahead and use that as a template for your others. Now, I'm gonna make two pinwheels. If you're only making one, you could use one piece of paper, or we can even play with having your paper be double-sided. So I'm gonna show you how to do two pieces of paper per pinwheel. But don't worry, if you only have one piece of paper, that's okay. So I just cut away that extra paper to make it a square. Now these are great for bookmarks or collaging, so I'm not gonna get rid of these papers. I'm gonna save them. So now that I have my squares, I'm gonna do my design. Now you could do a pattern, you could draw a picture, or you could keep it abstract. That's up to you. So I'm just gonna do a little pattern. I'm thinking about shapes and lines for this pinwheel. And maybe I'll do a curvy line or a wavy line. And maybe I'll do another curvy line. Now maybe I'll do straight line, another straight line. Maybe I'll have these lines repeat like a pattern. So what should come next if I'm doing a pattern? Do another straight line. And now I'll do the curvy line. And I'll end with the dots like I have up there. And I could go back with another color. I could say that one's done, and I'll move on. Maybe I'll do I like the orange with this green paper. So I could do the same pattern, or maybe I'll do a different pattern. And this can be as complicated or as easy as you like. And like I said before, I'm just thinking about lines and shapes. And so I have thick lines and thin lines. My thick line is a straight line. My thin line is a wavy line. And now I'm ready to glue or tape these two pieces together. Now remember, a little bit of glue goes a long way, so I'm just gonna do my outlines, so around it, and then I'm also gonna put a couple of lines through the center. But I'm not covering every single inch with glue. And now I'm lining them up. I'm gonna rub for a couple of seconds. And now we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna cut on the corners. And this is how we're gonna make the pinwheel. So we're gonna go to the corner and we're gonna stop before we hit the center. We're not gonna go all the way to the center. And now we're gonna rotate our paper and we're gonna cut again. But again, leave some space. Don't cut all the way to the center. And we're doing that on all four corners. So you'll see now there's some space left in the middle. We're gonna be putting our points to the center. So I'm gonna put a little dab of glue right there in the middle. Now you could just hold it with your finger, but I find it easier to put glue. And we don't want to crease these, so we're going to hold it. Now we're going to rotate. We're not going to bring this one down. We're skipping. So one, skip, bring this next one down, bring it to the center, hold it down. Now I like to rotate my paper, skip this one, go to the next one, bring it to the center, hold it down, skip, bring it down. So now we have all four coming to the center. Gotta make sure they overlap because that's where our pin's gonna go through. So bring it to the center. You might have to put a little bit more glue down. And you can see that they all overlap now. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna take our thumbtack or a pin. Now, you might need a parent to help you with this. Be careful. We're gonna push it through all the layers of the paper. So now that it's through, you can tell all the layers were caught. I just pulled it out though. All the layers were caught and it's coming through the back. Now, if you had, my eraser is almost all the way gone, but if you had a pencil with an eraser, you could just push it right into the eraser. There we go. Now, even if your eraser is all the way gone, you can still actually push it into the metal because there's a eraser inside the cap. So there we go. I have my pinwheel attached and now it can move. And you can go ahead, you can make yourself a second one with other colors. And you see how you see both sides, both beautiful colors, both beautiful designs.
So I hope you had fun making your pinwheel. Go outside with it, see what happens when the wind interacts or what happens when you blow on it. I hope you had fun making both sides and designing your colorful, beautiful pinwheel right in time for the holiday weekend. So I hope you guys have a wonderful time. Have a safe, fun weekend. And remember, if you like this video, hit the like button. Comment below with what you'd like to see in the future or how yours turned out. And I'd love to see photos of them. And remember, hit subscribe so you get notified every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday a new video comes out. Have a good weekend. Bye!